I'd go to the moon in a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again. But going to Mars should be one of the next series of steps that humans do. The first step should be going back to the moon for a number of technical reasons.
Why has nobody been to the moon in such a long time?
That's not an 8-year-old's question. That's my question. I want to know, but I think I know. Because we didn't go there, and that's the way it happened. Go there, and that's the way it happened. And if it didn't happen, it's nice to know why it didn't happen. So in the future, if we want to keep doing something, we need to know why something stopped in the past that we wanted to keep it going.
For a number of technical reasons and exploration reasons, and then after that, Mars, maybe a high orbit in Venus atmosphere, maybe going to Europa. There's all kinds of targets to go to, places of interest in our solar system. The only limit to a human future is in our own imagination.
Or whatever you are.
I'm Don Pettit.
You know, here's Don Pettit. He's drinking coffee, right, out of a bag, showing how it sticks to the bag. And he just finishes, and he lets it go. This is a CGI cup. And the coffee is also CGI. Watch. The coffee gets out of sync with the cup, right? Something goes wrong, and it gets out of sync just for a second. And they quickly take this video down off their website, but we've already downloaded it.
Science and science fiction are essentially the same.
Why don't you swear in the Bible that you walked on the moon? Why don't you swear in the Bible that you walked on the moon?
I'm not trying to get
you
in the middle of anything.
You tell him to get out of here.
This is a hotel.
We'll call the police. We pay. Come on in here. We'll call the police.
You like that?
Why don't you swear in the Bible that you walked on the moon?
It doesn't, sir. I don't have nothing to do with this. But
okay.
You cannot solicit on this.
You're the one who said you walked on the moon when you didn't. Calling the kettle black, if I ever thought of it. Saying
Will
I misrepresented
get it
myself.
Away from me.
You're a coward and a liar and a thief.
Two things, making meals and babies.
Oh, boy. There you go again.
That's true. Look at the cave women. Why do you think your cave women was created with short legs and fat butts?
don't know, Arch, but I'm sure you got a good answer.
So they couldn't run fast, so the men could catch them and force them to make the meals and the babies.
Well, weren't there any cave women with long legs and skinny butts that could run faster than the men?
They'd have to bring down with a rock.
Now I'm starting to catch on. And what about the cave men with the short legs and fat butts that couldn't catch any women?
Well, they was probably your first fags.
America's heritage as the world's greatest spacefaring nation. The essence of the American character is to explore new horizons and to tame new frontiers. But our destiny beyond the Earth is not only a matter of national identity, but a matter of national security. So important for our military, so important, and people don't talk about it. When it comes to defending America, it is not enough to merely have an American presence in space. We must have American dominance in space.
Journey into tomorrow, a journey to another planet, a manned mission to Mars.
I should tell you that the first mission is scheduled to land on Mars on July the 4th, 1997, Independence Day.
Using the Crew Exploration Vehicle, we will undertake extended human missions to the moon as early as 2015, with the goal of living and working there for increasingly extended periods of time. Human missions to Mars and to worlds beyond.
We were never able to see stars from the lunar surface or on the daylight side of the moon by eye without looking through the optics. I don't recall during the period of time that we were photographing the Sona Cuprella what stars we could see.
I don't remember seeing any.
Neil, you were a little bit concerned. You said about...
Whilst
from
in
Mark
space,
Cameron. This is from Mark Cameron.
Whilst in space, have you ever looked away from Earth into the black void?
Because you can see the stars.
Oh yeah.
Pretty much all the time you can see the stars.
Yeah. We were never able to see stars from the lunar surface or on the daylight side of the moon.
I don't remember seeing any.
Remember here, if you're making still water, it's always flat, always level. So every little line that you put in it must be basically flat. You can go anywhere you want to go with it, but you have to keep them straight. In still water, it's always flat, always.
But I just have to say, pretty bluntly here, we've been there before. There's a lot more of space to explore and a lot more to learn when we do.
We'll establish a foundation for an eventual mission to Mars. And perhaps someday to many worlds beyond. We dare to dream big, and that's what our country is doing again. We're dreaming big.